So welcome to the third game of the season for the Reading Rockets D-Squad. They're hosting the North Middlesex Cowboys today. And the captains go out for the toss. Number 22, Brendan Lindmark. Number 70, Thomas Lafferty. 41, Daniel Agamy. And number 12, Andrew Jackvinny. So first game of the season was a win at Birch Meadow here against Wilmington. Second game last week, they fell to Saugus, and today at 1-1 hosting North Middlesex. So Reading getting pumped up, preparing for the first play of the game. Captains have greeted the rest of the team and getting ready to start the game. So North Middlesex will start with the ball. Reading defense on the field, so it'll be first and 10 for the Cowboys at their 35. North Middlesex quarterback under center. It's a pitch along the right side, number 11, sweeping it up to the outside, tackled by several Reading Rockets defenders. I see 41, Daniel Agamy, Sean Tesoro, number 6, on the play. So it'll be second and 9 from the 36-yard line. Nice play by the Reading Rockets defense. Hold them to a 1-yard gain. Fake pitch, quarterback keep up the middle. Number 6, Sean Tesoro with a tackle after pickup of 2 or 3 yards by the quarterback. So third down and 6 to go for the Cowboys. Reading trying to stop them on this first drive from the 36. So quarterback going back to pass. He's going to keep it. Reading giving chase. It's tackled at the 38-yard line. Number 11, Zachary Labriola, leading the tacklers.
And Riley Leonard, number 9 as well, with the chase.
So fourth and 6 to go for North Middlesex. Reading Rockets defense. Good start. So North Middlesex elects to punt, kicks the ball, takes a hop. Good bounce for North Middlesex. Reading will fall on the ball. Oh, they'll stay on their feet. Bring it back to the 35-yard line. So great opening stop by the Reading defense. It'll be first and 10 for the offense from the 36-yard line. Jack Doherty in the backfield. Takes the snap, quarterback keep, run up the middle. Picks up a few, close to the 40-yard line. Second and 7 now from the 39-yard line for Reading. Doherty again in the backfield. Oh, I'm sorry, that's Brendan Lindmark. A good run up the middle. One man to beat, but tackled at the 49-yard line. Nice run there by Brendan Lindmark. So Reading Rockets second and 7. Doherty with the snap, quarterback keep, up the middle, picks up a few, breaks it free, he's up at the 30, 25, 20, one man to beat, and gets tackled at the 14-yard line. First down for Reading. So first and 10 from the 14-yard line. Reading with a nice opening drive here. Merkel wide right, and Doherty and Tucker in the backfield. Snap is to Doherty, fakes the quarterback keep, throws it to number 22, Brendan Lindmark. Incomplete pass. Rockets faking that quarterback keep up the middle. Looked like they had the defense fooled. So now it'll be second down, second and 10. Similar formation, Merkel wide right. Doherty and Tucker in the background, whistle, and it looks like it'll be a false start on the offense, on Redding. So it'll now be second and 14 at the 19-yard line. Snap is to Brendan Lindmark, up the middle, to the cuts left, and tackled at the 14-yard line. Pretty much back where they were play ago. So third down from the 14-yard line, about 10 to go for the Rockets. Again, Merkel will be wide right. Snap is to Doherty, up the middle, cuts to the right, has some space, to the 10, to the 5, and close to the first down marker. Fourth and 2 now for Redding. So let's see if the Rockets can at least pick up the first down here deep in Cowboys territory. Fourth and 2. Snap is directed to Doherty, fakes the run, and a complete pass to Brendan Lindmark, and touchdown Rockets. A nice establishment of the fake of the run up the middle, and had Lindmark wide open. So a similar play than that they had a few plays ago where they had an incomplete pass, so it's 6-0, a good start for Redding.
Yeah, they.
So Redding scores the touchdown on their opening drive, going for the extra point. If successful, this is a one-point attempt. Doherty with the keeper and runs it up the middle and through for the extra point. 7-0 Rockets. Strong start both defensively and offensively here against North Middlesex. Reading Rockets cheerleaders, D squad cheering on their team. So North Middlesex with the ball now at the 35-yard line. Direct snap to number 40, running up along the right side, up the middle, nice tackle at the 35-yard line, no gain by a few Reading defenders. Number 71, Adrian Munez.
And number 12, Andrew Jackmany in there as well.
So it'll be second and let's call it 9 from the 36-yard line. Rockets defense playing strong. Snap to number 40, sweep along the right side. He laterals it to number 11. Good reaction by Redding, stopping that edge sweep.
George Rogers, number 4 in there on the first hit.
So third and 9 from the 36-yard line. North Middlesex trying a kind of an option play on the last play along the right side. Fake pitch, number 40, the quarterback going back for a pass. And almost completed. Nice defense, though, by number 22, Brendan Lindmark. Also, number 51 going to greet him, Ryan Bonacci. Good defense here by the Reading Rockets. So with a 4th and 9, North Middlesex will elect to punt again. Kick is handled by the Rockets, but touched and loose. Recovered by number 22, Brendan Lindmark. A little slightly dangerous play there, but Redding gets the ball back. So Nathan Berry in the huddle calling the play. Mark Tango, Michael Olson in as well. Number 20, Thomas Merkel along the right side, split wide. Berry gets the snap, run up the middle to the 40, 35, that's Jack Doherty, 30, 25, breaking it open, 20, 15, 10. He better not slow down, and he's in the end zone. Jack Doherty, touchdown. And it is 13-0, Rockets. Strong start. So, nice touchdown run there by Jack Doherty. Redding going for the extra point, going for the run, 1 point conversion attempt here. Berry in the backfield, Tucker next to him. Berry back for the pass to Tucker. Tackled near the goal line, just short. And the extra point is unsuccessful, but the Redding Rockets, strong opening start. A 13-0 lead here in the first quarter. So a minute 39 left in the first quarter. North Middlesex will have the ball at the 35, and it looks like a timeout out on the field. So after that timeout, North Middlesex will retake the field. Redding Rockets defense ready at the 35-yard line, first and 10 for the Cowboys. Hand off up the middle and brings it up a few yards to the 38-yard line. Ryan Bonacci, number 51, in on that last play. It'll be second and 7 from the 38-yard line. Looks like some offsides on the Redding defense. Pickup of a few up the middle. We'll see if North Middlesex accepts the penalty. So the Cowboys accept the penalty. It'll be second down and 2 from the 43-yard line. Quarterback sneak right up the middle, still on his feet until he's brought down. It'll be a first down after a pickup of 3 yards. Whistle on the field. So Ryan Bonacci and Adrian Muniz in on that last play up the middle. And that will be the end of the first quarter with the score Redding Rockets 13, North Middlesex Cowboys 0. And for the player profile starting this week, David, what do we've got here for the Redding Rockets?
Thanks, Mark. Another great job announcing for Redding Rockets today by Mark and Mike. Our first player of the game, help you get to know the players a little bit, is Georgie Rogers for the D squad, number 4. Georgie's a fourth grader at Birch Meadow. His favorite New England Patriots player is Rob Gronkowski. I think that one's going to be a popular one. And his favorite non-football athlete is Big Poppy David Ortiz.
Big Poppy will also be a popular selection. So strong opening quarter. Thanks, Dave. And Mike, I think that Redding Rockets, a nice strong start compared to last week. It's a slightly different team, I think.
Here's a handoff up the middle, North Middlesex, who just got their first down a couple plays ago. Pickup of about 2 yards. Close to midfield. So North Middlesex here, 2nd and 8. At their own 48-yard line. Dropping back, big play.
Jackson
in the
Tucker, nice slowing down the play.
Whole horde of Rockets here to finish him off. Looks like for about a 4-yard loss on the play.
Looked like Jack.
Mason. So here we go with a 3rd and 12 for North Middlesex. After that 4-yard loss in the last play. Defense! pitched up the middle. Nice quick tackle by number 12.
Andrew Jackman, flying from the backfield.
So faced with a fourth and long here. See if they go with a punt or elect to go for it. Looks like the punting unit may be coming on. Okay, here we go. Fourth and 11. Here's the punt. Actually a pretty good one. Rolling down, rolling out of bounds at the 22-yard line of Reading. Good defensive stand there again by Reading. Here comes the Reading offense now. They've scored on their first two possessions. This will be their third possession, starting at their own 21-yard line. Here's a run up the middle. I believe that was Nathan Berry on the carry.
Correct, yeah.
Here comes Reading after that timeout. Second and 7 here from their own 24. Here's Nathan Berry again. Here he goes. Ooh, nice first down run.
Nice blocking by Ryan Fitzgerald on the right side there.
Okay, Redding's coming up to the line after that good first down run. First and 10 from the 35. Nathan Berry again. Good push from the offensive line. Get a couple of yards.
Keep those feet moving.
Okay, number 99 for North Middlesex. Walking off the field under his own power. And second down here for Reading. Mark Tango in. Nathan Berry bringing in the play. Okay.
Fitzgerald wide right.
Here's Nathan Berry again at the middle. Pickup of about 3. Reading continuing to run the ball well, moving the ball up the field. Reading up to the line. Number 21, Ryan Fitzgerald. Wide left. Oh, timeout on the field. Looks like a timeout for Reading here. Here's Dave with another Reading Rockets player profile.
Thanks, Mike. Our second player of the game for the Reading Rockets is Sean Tesoro. Sean's number 6. And he's a 6th grader at Coolidge. His favorite New England Patriots player is LeGarrette Blount. And his favorite non-football athlete, pretty cool one, Usain Bolt.
Okay, Reading here with 3rd down and about 3 at their 40 after that timeout. Here comes number 10, Nathan Berry again. Looks like he's through across for the first down. Excellent blocking again by the Reading offensive line. Another first down for Reading. Okay, Reading comes up to the line here, close to the 50.
Ryan O'Malley with a nice block on the last play.
It's a snap, Nathan Berry again, right up the middle. Pickup of about 3 or 4 yards. Okay, teams coming back on the field after the timeout. Got about 5 minutes left to go here in the second quarter. Reading up 13-0. Second about 6 here to go for Reading at the, we have a penalty here on Reading.
Delay of game, potentially. No.
Okay. 5-yarder marked off against Reading. Number 7, Patrick Daly on the carry. Gets a couple. Okay, Redding here now, 3rd and long. Patrick Daly bringing the play back in. North Middlesex looking for a stop here, as Redding has scored on both their possessions so far. Number 11.
Nice quarterback run.
It's number 11, Zachary Labriola on the carry. Okay, Redding come to the, up to the line. About 4th and about 6, right over midfield. Nathan Berry handoff. Jack Dougherty. A few yards, but will be short. So North Middlesex will take over here. About 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter, a second quarter. Okay, Redding defense on the field. It's a handoff up the middle, immediately stopped. Looks like George Rogers was right there for the first of the hit. Quite a few defenders.
Looks like Tucker and Bonacci on the stop.
Redding defense playing extremely well today. I believe only one first down so far for North Middlesex as we come close to the halftime. 2nd and about 9. Pitch to the right.
Flag
in the play. Pick up about 2 or 3 yards.
Looks like holding on North Middlesex.
Yeah. So after the 10-yard mark off against North Middlesex, looks like we...
I'll tell you what, Mike, I'm watching Bonacci and Munez, who are having an awesome game today on the defensive line.
Here's a pitch to the left. Quickly tackled by a number of Rockets. George Rogers in at the end of it, but 3 or 4 Rockets seem to be in on every tackle. Third and 12 here for North Middlesex. Going for the pass. He's got someone open. Overthrown.
Jack Vinny on the coverage. Nice defense.
So 4th and long here. North Middlesex punt units on the field again here. 1:15 to go. Good snap. Good punt. Redding lets it go. And looks like it'll end up about the 24, 25-yard line of Redding. So the Redding will get the ball back with about a minute to go. Leading 13-0.
Redding cheerleaders obviously very happy to see Rockets up 13-0 as we approach the end of the first half.
Here comes Redding's offensive unit with about a minute to go to work with here before halftime. Nathan Berry. Nope, we got a fumble.
Recovered
Nathan
by Redding.
On it.
Yep.
Okay, Redding 2nd down here. About a 5-yard loss on the fumble. Number 5, up the middle. Jack Dougherty for 3 yards, and I believe that is halftime.
Well, so North Middlesex looks like they called a timeout to stop the clock with 14 seconds left.
Okay. After the North Middlesex defensive timeout, teams are back on the field. 14 seconds to go here in the second quarter. Handoff, Redding up the middle. Oh,
fumbles the ball.
Let's see who's going to get this.
And North Middlesex recovers.
So the North Middlesex timeout pays off for them as they get the ball back here with 6 seconds to go before halftime at the Redding 30. Okay, here we go with teams back in the field. North Middlesex should have enough time to run probably one play here with 6 seconds to go before the half. Let's see what kind of play they run here. Going back to pass, down the sideline, overthrows.
Just overthrown. And there's 1.8.
Okay, here comes North Middlesex. This will be the last play of the half here with just under 2 seconds to go. Drops back for the pass, under pressure. It's up in the Nice coverage by Brendan Lindmark on that as we go to the halftime. Reading ahead 13-0.
Strong half by Reading.
So at halftime, we're going to announce the next two players of the game for the D squad here. Next, we've got Zach Labriola, number 11. Zach's a fourth grader at Woodend. His favorite New England Patriot player is Julian Edelman. And a very interesting non-football favorite player for Zach is Cristiano Ronaldo. Definitely interesting there. I thought we would see mostly Gronks and Big Poppies on this list, but a couple interesting ones. And our fourth player of the game for today is Jeremiah Sanford. Jeremiah is number 52 for the Reading Rockets. He's a fourth grader at Joshua Eaton. And his favorite New England Patriots player is Deion Lewis. His favorite non-football athlete is LeBron James.
Devin.
So Reading will start off the second half with the ball. North Middlesex had the ball to start the game. So Reading up 13-0 to start the half. At their 35-yard line, first and 10, handoff. Up the middle, no gain. Jack Doherty with the ball. So Nathan Berry and his quarterback. Shotgun formation. Tucker next to him. Doherty behind him for the pass. Lindmark up the middle, near midfield. Nice completed pass from Berry to Brendan Lindmark. So that gets Reading a first down. It'll be first and 10 from the 47-yard line. Nice pass by Berry there. Looks like it'll be a false start there on Reading, which will bring them back 5 yards. So it'll be first and 15 now. Again, Berry, Tucker, and Doherty in the backfield. Berry takes a snap, handoff to Lindmark up along the left side, sweep along the edge, spins to the 46-yard line. Brendan Lindmark with a run. So it'll be second and 11, Fitzgerald wide left. Berry calling the snap. Back for a pass up the middle to Lindmark, and incomplete pass. That play seems to be pretty successful with Lindmark open up the middle. So third and 11 now from the 46-yard line. Number 21, Ryan Fitzgerald, wide right for the Rockets. And false start on Reading. It'll be back another 5. Oh, that was Merkel. So it'll be third and 16 from the 41 for the Rockets. Thomas Merkel wide right. Berry in the shotgun. Snap to Berry, fakes the run, pass to number 22, Brendan Lindmark, incomplete pass, and it'll be fourth down for the Rockets. So it'll be fourth and 16. Doherty in at quarterback. You have Jack Vinny on the left side and also Sean Crowley on the left, Brendan Lindmark on the right. Fourth and 16 from the 41. Jack Vinny in motion. Snap is to Doherty. It's a pass to Tucker. Looks to be an incomplete pass. And Reading will turn it over on downs to North Middlesex. Okay, so North Middlesex will have the ball now. Good field position at the 41-yard line, first and 10. Reading jumps offsides. Should be a 5-yard gain for North Middlesex. So it'll be first and 5 now for North Middlesex at the 36-yard line. It's a pitch number 11 on the right side, finding the edge, gets around the edge, and he's in the open field down near the 20-yard line. Pushed out of bounds by number 22, Brendan Lindmark. So the Cowboys with some momentum here now. Let's see what the Reading Rockets defense has to say about that. 21-yard line now for North Middlesex, first and 10. It's a fake pitch, and then the Reading Rockets defense in the backfield. Number 9, Riley Learned, in on the tackle, breaking up that play before it even started. So it'll be second down and 13 now at the 23-yard line. Back to pass, and it is an incomplete pass. And number 4, George Rogers, covering.
Good pressure on the quarterback there to for hurry the throw.
So it is now fourth and a mile for North Middlesex. They have to get to the 10-yard line. They are at the 32. Number 40 for North Middlesex, back to pass. Now he keeps the ball, runs it up the middle, and finds an edge, and he might get to the first down marker. He's awfully close. I think he got there. Long run, so Reading had them right where they wanted, North Middlesex, and it is a first down. So it is indeed a first down for North Middlesex, first and 10 at the, call it the 10-yard line, so it's I don't think that there'll be a first down marker beforehand, and they lose the ball,
fumble.
And looks like North Middlesex recovers. Is my head in your way? So about 4 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Third and goal from the 10 for North Middlesex. It's a pitch to number 11 on the right side, has some space,
getting
to the outside, and gets into the end zone for a touchdown for North Middlesex. And it's now 13-6. So North Middlesex going for the extra point, trying to make it 13-7. It's a fake pitch, it's a pass, and Jackson Tucker in the backfield, but still on his feet, the quarterback, and
nice tackle
by number 11, Zachary Labriola, to prevent that extra point, so it remains 13-6 Rockets. So with 3:51 left in the third quarter, Reading will get the ball at the 35-yard line. Snap is to Doherty, quarterback keep. He's got to run along the right side, try to find an edge. Tackled at the 40-yard line for a pickup of about five. So second and a long five for the Rockets offense. Snap is direct snap to Lindmark, who runs it up the middle and makes it past the first down marker. And looks like he's at the 45, 46-yard line, so keep those chains moving. So first and 10 for the Rockets now. Lindmark and Tucker in the backfield. At the 46-yard line, snap is again to Lindmark, runs it up the middle, and makes it to midfield for a pickup of about 4 yards.
Nice.
So it'll be second and 6 from midfield. Doherty in the backfield, taking the snap. Quarterback keep, up the middle, good space, good blocks, breaks it open. Still on his feet and brings half the North Middlesex defense to the 30-yard line with him. So nice blocking there by the Reading offensive line. Big pickup for Doherty. It's now first and 10 from the 31-yard line. Snap to Lindmark, cuts left, finding the edge. He finds the edge to the 20. Still on his feet to the 17-yard line. Nice run by Brendan Lindmark. So first and 10 now at the 18-yard line. You'll have Merkel wide right. Doherty and Tucker in the backfield. Nice lead block by Tucker. And Doherty picks up a few. When you run that play again, watch the lead block by Jackson Tucker to get. So with 58 seconds to go in the third quarter, Reading Rockets offense knocking on the door at the 9-yard line. The snap is to Lindmark, who runs it up the middle and gets tackled at the 5-yard line for a pickup of about 4.
First and goal here.
So it's going to be second and goal to go from the 5-yard line. Snap is to Doherty, who runs it up the middle, has some space, and will just be short of the goal line. It will be, I think, third and 1. So at the end of three quarters, it's 13-6 Rockets. Dave, what do we have for another Rockets player profile?
Thanks, Mark. Next player of the game is Danny Agami, number 41 for the Reading Rockets. If I can find him on the field, I would, but they're kind of running off with the coach. Danny is a fifth grader at Barrows. His favorite New England Patriot player is Deion Lewis, and his favorite non-football athlete is Derek Jeter. And last today for the players, we do have one coach profile we're going to mention as well, try to get everybody to know the coaches a little bit. But our final player of the game is Patrick Daly, number 7. And Patrick is a fourth grader at Barrows. His favorite New England Patriot is Julian Edelman. And his favorite non-football athlete is Mookie Betts. And our coach of the game is Coach Labs. Coach Labs' favorite player is Rob Ninkovich. And his favorite non-football athlete is Tim Wakefield.
And at the start of the fourth quarter, Doherty with a quarterback keeper close to the goal line, but just short. So Reading.
So third and goal here for Reading. There's the handoff left side.
Flag on the play.
Marks in, but a flag. Holding on the Reading. It'll be coming back. So Reading back to third and goal here after the mark off of the holding penalty.
Fitzgerald on the left side.
And Mark has it here of the left side, looking for some space. Really nothing there. Good tackle by North Middlesex. Fourth and goal here. Okay, Redding here with Jack Dougherty and Tucker in the quarterback position. Dougherty's looking to throw. Incomplete. So North Middlesex will take over here on downs. So Reading's defense now on the field. North Middlesex starting at their own 8-yard line, trailing 13-6. It's a handoff to the left side. He's finding some room again to the outside. All the way to the 30-yard line.
Sean DeSuro with a nice tackle.
North Middlesex seems to be finding some running room here in the second half. Okay, first and 10 here now. North Middlesex from their 30 after the big run. There's a pitch to the right. Number 41, number 6 right there to greet him.
Sean DeSoro. All over the field, Sean DeSoro.
Okay, second and about 8 or 9 here after the first down play. Another pitch back. Sweep to the left. Redding's got him in the backfield. Still growing, still going. He's finished off by a group of tacklers. Nice play by the Redding defense. So North Middlesex faced with a third and 13 here. From their 27. Quite a bit of movement. Back for a pass, rolling. Gonna keep it. Oh, number 12 right there to greet him.
Jack Vinny saying hello to the quarterback.
Fourth and long here now for North Middlesex. Oh. Looks like North Middlesex has got the, maybe going for a punt here. Yep, here it goes. Redding lets it roll. Another nice punt to the Redding 32. Okay, Redding's offense back in the field now after that good stop by the defense at their own 32. 5 minutes to go, up 13-6. There's a run by Jack Dougherty up the middle. Good push, still moving, still moving. Offensive line helping him along. Number 23, Jack Janes in there helping push him forward. Okay, Redding back after that nice 7-yard first down run.
About 4 minutes to go. Keep the ball.
Second and 3. Jack Dougherty keeps it over the right side. He's got a first down. Still moving. His offensive line pushing him forward again. Ryan O'Malley in there at the end to give him a little push.
Key first down.
Okay, Jack Dougherty brings in the play. Clock winding down here. First and 10 at the 49 of Redding. Number 22.
Lindmark.
Good tackle for a stop by North Middlesex. I think we have a timeout here to stop the clock. 3 minutes, 17 seconds to go. Okay, the teams come back up to the line of scrimmage after the timeout by North Middlesex to stop the clock. Second and 10 here. Shotgun snapped to Lindmark. Good carry holding onto the ball. Pick up of about 3. Clock continues to run. Okay. Okay, Reading back up to the line of scrimmage. Third and 7, right over midfield. Another run, keeper. North Middlesex there to greet him.
Interesting choice now.
Okay, 2 minutes, 11 seconds to go here. Reading up 13-6, big play here, fourth down.
Gotta get to the 41.
Looks like Reading trying to get North Middlesex to jump. They do not. Timeout Reading. Okay, here comes Reading offense back in the field. Good attempt to get North Middlesex to jump offsides. They did not, so here we go. Fourth and about 4. Here comes Jack Dougherty on the right side. He's got a first down and more. Great play by Reading. Okay, 2 minutes to go here now. After that big first down run by Jack Dougherty. Dougherty and Tucker in the backfield. Tucker keeps it right up the middle. Quick stop. The clock continues to run. Second down. Okay, 1 minute, 50 seconds to go. Second and 8. Looks like Lindmark to the left. It's taken down quickly, but the clock runs.
Reading obviously taking their time here. 1 minute to go.
Dougherty and Tucker. Dougherty keeps it up the middle. He's got room. He's through.
Close to the first down. I think he's got it.
Fourth and short. Oh.
They're moving the chains. That's a first down.
It is.
And that should do it.
Should be one more play here to finish out the game.
Great game by Reading. Both sides of the ball. 5 punts by North Middlesex. Tells you that the Reading Rockets defense really did a nice job. And obviously the offense scoring a couple of touchdowns.
Here we go, 10 seconds to go.
Suspect this will be a kneel, yes.
And there it is. Nice victory today by Reading, 13-6. Go to 2-1 on the season.
I think it was a strong start for Reading. First half, they really dominated. And I have to give credit to North Middlesex. They didn't give up and made it slightly tense at several times. Good start to the second half for North Middlesex, but Reading clamped down. And I think their defense really held their part of the bargain, forcing North Middlesex to punt quite a few times today.